One of the first videos I made was about Andrew Luck's field vision. And for a good reason. I mean, it seems like he just always sees what's going on in the field. Houston loves to play out of a base 3-4 formation. And here, they're going to be running a basic cover 3 out of that formation. This is the route concept that Indianapolis is going to be running, and they're going to have a route open at the top half of the screen. This ends up being too easy for Luck. He just looks up, reads the formation, and then throws it to the open man. When facing a guy like Andrew Luck, running basic schemes just isn't going to work out very well. So then for Houston, it becomes a pretty big dilemma. How do you stop someone who seemingly reads coverages in a split second? Well, the simple way is to get creative with your defensive play calling. Take this play, for example. As you see on the line, Houston has three men on their knees and two men standing up. Simple logic would tell you that the three Texans who are down will be rushing the passer, and one of the two defenders standing up will rush the passer while the other one bounces out. You don't know which one it could be, which is why the base 3-4 can be effective. However, you should still know that one of them will move forward and one of them will move back. But one of the things you're going to see the Texans do is they're going to be blitzing on this play. As you see, both Colts tackles are getting ready to block the two linebackers that were standing up. However, they're both going to just drop back into coverage. This then creates the pressure of a 7-man rush while only having to rush 5. Luck has no choice but to just try to dump it off to his halfback, and while he drops the pass, even if he ends up catching it, there was going to be nowhere to run and it wouldn't have been a big gain at all. Another good way to mix things up is by only having three Texans rush Andrew Luck. As you see here, this is the route concept that the Colts are running, and if it were to be a basic cover 2, for example, then there would be a wide open Colt in the middle of the field. However, instead of running a basic cover 2, Houston's going to end up dropping an extra man back in coverage. This means it's only going to be a 3-man rush. However, that gap in the middle of the field will now be closed up. This was a route concept specifically designed to beat a basic cover 2. But since there was the extra man in coverage, Luck has really nothing to do but just run for a couple of yards. You could also potentially bait someone into throwing an interception on this play if they read it's a cover 2, but don't see the extra linebacker drop back in coverage. However, Luck's smart enough to realize what's going on, and he was able to just take a couple of yards. This one's another interesting play call. It was the fourth down play in overtime, so it was a crucial point in this game. Really, whoever won this play was probably going to end up winning the football game. It's a cover 1 play, and there's a lot of man coverage. However, what they're going to do, instead of running a basic cover 1 hole, where only one linebacker drops back in the middle of the field, they're going to do something a little bit different, where they have two players drop back in coverage in the middle of the field. It's only a 3-man rush, however, this essentially completely takes away the entire middle of the field. Typically, to beat zone coverage is with a quick cut. However, if there were to be a quick cut, it would have to be towards the middle of the field. Because of this, Luck pretty much has no choice but to try to make a quick throw to a receiver. It's a defensive play that requires a perfect throw and a great catch. Luck ends up underthrowing it a bit, and the Colts end up not being able to convert. I really think the strategy on Houston coming into this weekend has to be to let your players be the ones making the plays. You want to force the Colts to have to beat you in one-on-one matchups. This play is a good example of that. This one actually is a basic cover 1 hole, and Luck's actually going to play it as well as you possibly could. He's going to do a great job of looking off Texans linebacker to the bottom half of the screen. This is going to set up a route that goes towards the middle of the field in a 1-on-1 matchup. This is pretty much as good of a situation as you want in man coverage. However, despite that, here Wright's going to make a great play and knocks the ball away. I think player for player, Houston has a better secondary than Indianapolis has receiving core. The one exception would be T.Y. Hilton. He's the guy that can really beat you. On this play, Houston's going to have a linebacker look at Indianapolis' halfback. If the halfback is blocking, then you rush the passer. If the halfback is running a route, then you follow the halfback. And since he is going to be blocking, this is essentially going to create a 5-man rush. From here, Houston's going to be running a cover 1 robber, which is almost the same thing as a cover 1 hole, except you have the safety taking away the middle of the field as opposed to a linebacker. The easiest way to beat something like this is a deep route towards the sidelines, and that's exactly what Luck's going to do. T.Y. Hilton ends up running a great route, and Andrew Luck makes a perfect throw to pick up a big gain. Also, if you look over at this angle, J.J. Watt's actually going to take a pretty poor route on this one. He has a 1-on-1 matchup, but instead of running to the outside to try to contain Luck, he's instead going to go straight after Colt's right tackle. If he broke to the outside, he probably would have been in a better position to make that play. I think he was expecting a tight end to help block him, which is why he ran that way. However, in hindsight, he should have ran to the outside, which would have allowed him to make a play on Luck. Basically, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I'm okay with getting beat on a play like that. When the only way to beat you is to have your defensive player of the year make a bad play, and then have a great throw and a great catch, that typically isn't going to happen too often, and you're going to be in good shape running plays like that. Typically, the problem with running a lot of man coverage is it allows a running back to then get free and get some yards. However, Houston's done a pretty great job in stopping Indianapolis' run game. In their two matchups, the Colts running backs have 64 rushing yards combined. Here's another good example of how man coverage can be effective against this Colts team.
As you see here, Houston's going to be running a relatively basic cover two man. It's again great defense by Houston's secondary, and nobody is open.
Luck has really no choice but to just pick a guy to try to throw to. Also worth mentioning, nobody is requiring safety help at this point. This is just every single Texan doing a good job of winning their one-on-one matchup. Luck has nothing open, and he's going to end up trying to force a throw here. It ends up being a bit of a high throw, and it gets tipped, and the safety's able to pick it off. While sure, you can't rely on a tipped ball ending up in an interception all the time, either way, it's probably going to be an incompletion because of the tight window Luck had to try to throw to. There's one more play that I thought was really interesting that I want to talk about. As you see here, this is one of the rare times you'll find the Texans running a 4-3 defense instead of a 3-4 defense. However, they're going to do something a little bit different here. They're going to have someone who's lined up as a defensive tackle drop back into coverage, and safety Andre Howe is then going to run straight to Luck. Also worth mentioning, J.J. Watt is lined up in the 9 technique, and they have another defensive tackle lined up in the 5 technique. This is basically going to force Colts right guard and tackle to have one-on-one matchups, and will give the person who's blitzing plenty of space. Also, to make that space bigger, you're going to see J.J. Watt do a very good job of running to a contained position, which is now going to open up that gap even wider. Luck has basically no time to throw, and has no choice but to try to dump it off to his halfback. Once again, even if it was completed, it wouldn't have gained much of anything, and it would have been a good play for Houston. Really, I think that's the key to stopping this Colts offense, and I fully expect Houston to be doing a lot of that. Now, every now and then, T.Y. Hilton is going to get open, and every now and then, Luck is going to make a perfect throw. However, Houston has a lot of really talented players. Getting creative at the line and running a lot of man coverage is going to force Luck to either make a perfect throw or force a receiver to run a great route to get open quickly. I fully expect Houston to be running a lot of coverages like this on Saturday. And if Luck doesn't have a great game, it could be bad news for Indianapolis.